Hey, welcome to my live stream tonight. Tonight I wanted to do something a little bit different, actually, by special request. I'm going to be talking about my strategy for painting greens in plein air. So I'll get started with that. And let's see here. I'm just going to pull up my video. And hopefully, there we go. Okay, so on my palette, this is what I did is this particular palette here. I've been using this for my studio painting because I'm employing just a different strategy really here. I wanted to stick with these colors just because I'm challenging myself with these. But this is more of my plein air range of colors that I use when mixing greens. Excuse me. Hey Greg, it's good to see you. I've actually got things working so they look like they're in the right order tonight. Canvas is on the left, paint's on the right. So thanks for checking in. What we have is a phthalo green yellow shade, and this is actually this particular yellow shade is a Holbin brand, and I really like it a lot because when I mix this particular green with alizarin crimson, I just get some really rich darks that are really nice. So there's that. And then below that, I have cadmium orange and Indian yellow, and then I have cad yellow light, and then French ultramarine, cerulean blue, and alizarin crimson. And these are all the colors that come into play when I'm mixing green. Hey Larry, thanks for checking in. By the way, your pond is looking pretty spectacular, and those purple beans that you keep cutting, I wish I had some of those up here in Michigan. But anyway, so what I do first is basically I do some work in here, and I sort of figure out, you know, what kind of combinations do I have available to me. And so, as you know, I usually mix. I use my brush to mix. I don't actually mix with a palette knife or anything. So if we take cad yellow light, and then we mix our two different blues with that, we'll start out with ultramarine blue. So we're going to have those two, and those are going to give me a very specific green. So we'll take the cad yellow light, take a little of the ultramarine blue, and that gives me this green, which actually has quite a bit of blue in it. And I'm looking over here to see, yeah, that's showing up pretty good on the video. So and then I do the same thing. I take the cad yellow light again, and I actually mix a little of cerulean with it, and this is going to give us a different blue, which I use cerulean a lot in the sky. Sorry, I forgot to, I wanted to put these two up there just as a reference point. So, so then we have cad yellow light, and, it's going to be a lot of brush washing in this exercise. So, and then we'll take the, cerulean blue and drop that in here. And then I've already mixed that color, so I'll grab some of that. So that's right here. So that's this blue. And again, it's got a lot more sky color in it. And then I do the same with my Indian yellow. So we'll take the Indian yellow, we'll pop that over here, and we'll make another block of it over here. There's still quite a bit of cad yellow light in there. But that's okay. Let's grab some of that. Drop that, And then we'll use our two blues with that as well. So we'll take our Indian yellow, and we're gonna mix our French ultramarine with that. And you're gonna notice right away just how warm this blue is. But first I gotta grab my blues. So even though we already know what these are, you know, just put them down anyway. So ultramarine, and we'll pick up some cerulean, put that over here, and you'll see the different blues that we're gonna get here. Okay, so this is the first one. This is the ultramarine, and so this Indian yellow tends to be pretty transparent, so that's why it's kind of mixing this way. But and you can already see how warm that green is compared to this green over here that's actually mixed with the cad yellow light. Just a very warm. Very warm green. And then we'll do the same with the cerulean. So we'll get some Indian yellow down here, mix that with some cerulean, and that's just going to give us another warm green, but it actually has a lot of sky color in it. So definitely not as cool as that, definitely not as warm as that. And on my palette, you know, I have basically a warm and cool of each color. So that's kind of the strategy that I use for the colors that I have on my palette. So with this particular starting point, the next place I go is I tend to modify my greens with their complement in two different directions. So I'll modify the green with obviously its complement is red, so but I'll modify it with both cad orange, and I'll modify it with alizarin crimson, and that takes it in two different directions, but they become very very helpful and useful along the way. So let's start over here. And I'm just gonna take a little cat orange here. And then I'll take some alizarin crimson kind of below that, just to show you where we're headed with those two. So that's alizarin and the cat orange. And first I'll mix up some of that color. So we'll take some of our cad yellow lights, we'll get some French ultramarine, get that mixed up, and then we're going to take that and we're going to modify that in two different directions. We're going to start out with the cad orange, and so I'll put some of that in here, and this is going to take what's a cool color, a cool green to start with, and it's going to make it very warm. So this particular cat orange from M. Graham is really saturated, so I have to be careful how much I actually put in there. But so that green moves this direction, which is actually closer to this range, but a lot more of an olive color. And then I'm gonna use the other side. I'll pick up some alizarin down here. And the alizarin is just like the cat orange. It's very saturated, so but I'll pick that up and we'll drop that one down here. And then you can see just how that one changed. With that. And then we'll do the same with the next one. So we'll take our Indian yellow. I'm sorry, we'll take our cad yellow light, and now we'll use our And then we're going to take this one two different directions. We're going to take a maybe I should put the orange up there first. So, just so we don't lose track of what we're actually mixing it with. So, so we're going to have cat orange again right here. And we're going to have alizarin crimson down here again. And now we're going to take our mix here and we're going to add cat orange to it. So we're going to come to the top side here and we're just going to bring that in here. Again, that gets crazy strong. So I actually have to go back with a little bit of the blue and a little bit of the yellow. And so this is gives us this color here. And then we'll grab this lower section of it and we'll just mix in some of our blue and some of our yellow. And that takes it this direction. Similar to this one, but a lot cooler. And I hope you can actually see that on the camera. Oh, hey, Patrick. Thanks for checking in, man. Patrick says, I have a fresh box of 16 Crayolas ready to go. Patrick's a friend of mine who actually lives in San Diego. Patrick and I are actually working on the framework for a podcast. So that'll be something that'll be coming up in the future. So you'll be wanting to watch out for that, because as you're already familiar with my Tuesday drives, you just never know what I'm going to say or talk about. So it could be interesting. Patrick used to live here in Michigan, and we were pretty good friends. So glad to see that relationship continue, buddy. All right, so... now we just do that same strategy over again. We've got our orange here. Patrick probably had to steal those crayons from his daughter. And then we'll have the, I didn't have to clean that yet. I was going to drop some orange over here. Just so we don't lose track of what we're actually mixing with. And it'll take the red, and it'll drop that down here. All right, now we're getting dots all over the place, but all right, so scrape this off a little bit. So now we start with our Indian yellow and French ultramarine. French ultramarine, and that'll get us started on this part. So we have our Indian yellow, French ultramarine. So we'll start with that pool. Should be that, yep, definitely that. And then we're going to grab some of the cat orange. We're gonna mix that into the top portion here. And that's going to give us this color, which needs just a touch more blue in it. Didn't want it to go quite that far. It's more like that. And then we're going to do the same. Let's see, Indian yellow and French ultramarine. It's a little darker value of it. Should be same. Yep. And then we're gonna
gonna take some alizarin crimson, mix it into that. And like we said, it too can have a tendency to take over the mix, so we'll just go back in with some yellow and some red. Now you can see just how warm this color got. So and now we're going to do the same with our last group here. So we're going to take the Indian yellow and cerulean blue, and then we're going to shift that with the orange on the top side here. Got a little orange, some color, some blue. Okay, so that's this one. Really nice rich green there. Very warm, late summer green. And this next one you'll see is gonna be even more so. Because we're gonna take that same color and grab a little more here. Make sure we're still in the family. Yep. And we'll pick up some alizarin. Mix it in with that. And this is a really nice late summer green right here. Very dark, very rich. Okay. So now you can see this full range of greens. That are left over, and Wednesday. I don't know if you saw what Patrick said or not, but he said that the podcast is going to be called Wednesday Crash. You wouldn't be the first person that worries about me driving and talking all the time, but anyway, that's really funny. So here's the strategy that's employed with this is taking this range of greens, and you can already see how blue these greens are, and these greens actually have a lot of blue in them as well. And if I mixed them, I can lean these either direction. So and this is important because I can take the cad yellow light, and I can take the ultramarine blue and just mix the base color again, except this time I'm shifting it with more blue. So if I drop that over here on this side, you can see how that color shifted. So now it's a lot more to the blue side. And this is what I do when I'm painting trees that are in the distance. So I try and stay in this cooler range of colors, and I paint my distant trees with those, because they're further away, they're taking on a lot of sky color, because we do the same with the cerulean blue. So we take the cerulean blue and we mix the yellow with it, but then we shift it toward blue, so we add a little more blue to it, and you can see that we shift this one to the blue side, and it actually becomes, you know, almost a turquoise color. And if I make a half tone of that, you can really kind of see the direction that color went. So I mean, it actually went that direction. So this would be my strategy for my distant tree line. So I'll just show you here. So if I have some distant trees, and I'll just kind of paint them over here. So I have this distant tree line back here. I'm going to use this range to start with because it's shifted towards sky color. Because as you know, things that get, when they get further away from us, they pick up a lot more of the sky color. So, so I just throw that in there and you can see what I did. And, and then we'll take actually some of the dark, and that can work its way down here into the bottom of that. Kind of down here where all the stuff grows. You can just go ahead and throw that in here. And then as soon as you take that and you bring, let me bring in some blue here. I kind of want this yellowish green ground. It's going to be a lot lighter because it's picking up a lot of the sky color. But let's just say that the grass is in this range, kind of this range here. That's in the distance. So I lay that in, and I'm still keeping it sort of shifted toward blue. So let's take a little more of the sky color in that, and I'll actually lighten the value just a touch. Whoops. Sky color. And I just want more blue in that because that's too, So I just shift that to blue. And then I can actually just make this a little bit darker here. Okay, I'm not trying to actually make a painting, but I'm just trying to illustrate this for you. And then as these, as the trees get closer to you, where you can see a lot more of them, they actually will pick up this kind of warm, they'll be more in this warm range. So then we can shift to the Indian yellow, in our French ultramarine, and we can start out with kind of a dark. Since a lot of this tree line might be in shadow, then I'll just shift this toward the blue side here, because I kind of paint light to dark, so, or dark to light, I'm sorry. So basically laying this color down, so I took these two and I shifted this color to the blue side. So if we have a tree that's sitting right here in the foreground, let's see, I need a lot more paint, so I'm gonna mix a little more here. And I'll shift it a little more to the blue side. It just sets itself just nicely in front of that distant tree without any trouble at all. It's already, because it's so warm, you can see how it's already sitting really far in front of that. And if you want even a deeper shadow, just shift it further using the blue, and then maybe the shadow down here in the bottom is even deeper, and maybe, you know, down on the ground where it's casting shadow is even deeper yet. But then you end up with all of these really nice warm greens in there, and then you take that same color and you shift it toward the yellow side, and maybe change the value just a little bit. And then where the light's coming in, you can actually bring that, bring some of that color in here. So, like so. And then this grass that's in the foreground, maybe this gets really brighter in here, and this is where I would alter things sometime. If I want a really nice sort of electric green, and understand that I'm intentionally kind of pushing these colors in different directions here. But I can go back in here. If this is too blue, all I did was take my mix and shift it back toward the green side over here. And then you can just work some of that back in, and it'll still kind of retain that blue look to it without being a really strange color that doesn't relate to the trees that are in front of it. Obviously the ground color is a lot lighter because it's picking up a lot of the sky, so you can just stay in that same range and shift it. But if I want a really good highlighted color, a highlighted green that I want to use, I will act. That's where I bring in my my green, phthalo green yellow shade. So just as an example, so if I take a cad yellow light and I grab a little, just a dab of the phthalo green yellow shade, I get a green that's just completely electric. You can see that here. It's almost a neon green. But the good thing is I can shift that with either by using orange or Indian yellow, and I can make it warmer this way because it's pretty cool as it is there. I can warm that up, or I can take some of the blue, and I can actually bring that in, and that will actually shift it just a little bit so that it's not quite so electric as it was. And I can put that in. And then that gives you a really, really warm color. And again, I'm intentionally exaggerating a little bit, just so you can get a feel for this. But the next step here would be, if there are highlights in this mix, then all you have to do is go back to that mix, and you can either bring in your cad yellow light into that mix, and that will give you some really nice ability to highlight this tree if you are so inclined. So wherever those highlights might be. And that is pretty much how I approach it. Now, this is sort of a spring green strategy, but as the year goes on, these trees are actually going to shift into this range. So it's going to be more of what we have over here. It's going to be Indian yellow. It's going to be ultramarine blue. And then we're going to take that, and our shadow colors will probably they'll be a lot warmer. So maybe just a touch of blue, but not a lot. But we'll end up with a color that's been shifted to the red side over here, and that'll give us a really nice warm a really nice warm shadow color over here. So depending on the type of tree that we're looking at, maybe it's one of those kind of brown cedars that we have around here, and sometimes the shadow areas will be pretty warm. So they tend to go to the red side, and late in summer, actually, all of these trees around here anyway, they sort of start to look that way as well. And then you can just continue to shift this blue to the green side. Add more blue to get to the green side, and then you can actually come in here with some deeper color. just by shifting that blue, coming up with these sort of browns. And then for the shadow of this tree's laying out here, I just brought in some ultramarine blue kind of into that shadow area. And if I need a deeper shadow, I just keep adding some more ultramarine into that same mix and drop that in. And we end up with a nice deep green. This one's a little cooler. This one's a lot warmer. But you can see that in this range here. We were over here, and then we shifted and we went over here. So all right, hopefully you will have a lot of questions for me if I've completely confused you, but Sarah actually made this request that I talk about my strategy for greens, and so there you have it. That's what goes through my head when I'm painting lots of greens, and I think it was maybe this painting kind of kicked that whole thing off, because this was early morning, and these were all backlit, so these ultramarine blues, blue greens in here kind of all came from this range here with a lot of ultramarine in them, and that's how I got to this point to start with. So anyway, thanks so much for checking out my live feed, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification so you don't miss anything that I'm up to. And I'll catch you later.